Trayvon Martin. You know, when I go to the store, when I'm running out and I throw something on, it's raining, they don't know the difference if it's the congressman, the mayor, you got that hoodie on, and somebody makes it, you end up dead. The next person has always been a fighter for justice. As a very young man, me and him both are not so young anymore, and he's actually running a big campaign around jobs, calling attention to the economy and what we're spending and the war machine and create jobs for people. But certainly he has been on every issue that involves our people. The chairman of the People's Organization for Progress, Larry Ham.
I am.
What do we want? When do we want it? What do we want? When do we want it? No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
No justice.
No peace.
If there ain't gonna be no justice,
there ain't gonna be no peace.
Thank you very much. I'm very glad to be here this afternoon, albeit for a most unfortunate cause, but I do want us to give a big hand to the mayor and the leadership here for having this rally today. Give them a big hand because they are doing the right thing, the kind of thing that we elected them to do, to give leadership to our community on issues that affect us, whether these issues originally occur in Irvington, New Jersey, or whether they occur in Sanford, Florida. Because this problem is not a Sanford, Florida problem. It's not an Atlanta, Georgia problem. It's not a Raleigh, North Carolina problem. It is a national problem. This is a national problem. And although I know that Trayvon was killed because he fit a certain stereotype, this is a matter of racial justice. Because had a young white fella had a hoodie on and had Skittles in his hand and the Arizona iced tea, he'd be alive with his parents today. Trayvon wasn't killed because of what he was wearing. He wasn't killed because of the kind of language he used. He was killed because he was black. And the fact of the matter is that last week was the anniversary of Martin Luther King's assassination. And we stand here today in the name of two assassinations, the assassination of Martin Luther King and the assassination of Trayvon Martin. This is a matter of racial justice. This country is as racist today in 2012 as it was in 1968. We have to tell the truth. The first step toward justice is telling the truth. This is not an isolated incident. I just got back from Raleigh, North Carolina this morning, and I can tell you the people down there are saying we got a Trayvon Martin in every town across the South. So we call today, yes, we call for the arrest of George Zimmerman, but we call for an end to racial profiling all across this nation. And not just in Florida, but right here in New Jersey on the racial profiling turnpike and Garden State Parkway. This is a national problem. I say they say an international problem. We want the arrest of George Zimmerman. But we also want a federal investigation into the Sanford Police Department, because we stand here today, 44 days after the death of this young man. If you or I had gone out and taken an innocent life, we'd be in the jail now. We wouldn't even see the light of day. We go from the jail to the court and to the prison. But 44 days later, somebody took an innocent life and they didn't even get a parking ticket, man.
something is wrong with this picture. We want justice. We want it now. We want a federal investigation into the Sanford Police Department. We know the facts of the case. We know the senior investigator on the scene filled out his report and said this was homicide. And he knew justice might be subverted. So he took out an affidavit on his position that can be shown to you today. They knew that night this was murder. They knew that night this wasn't self-defense. The police told Zimmerman, he said, I'm going to follow this young man. The police said, stay in your car. He wasn't acting in self-defense. He was the aggressor in this situation. And I tell you, as we stand here today, justice is already on the verge of being subverted because the special prosecutor that has been appointed in this case has said that she's not going to convene a grand jury. That automatically tells us there's not going to be any first-degree murder conviction. The best that they can get in this case is manslaughter. But if this had been a white person killed by a black man, they'd be looking at a murder charge. Right now, we got to tell the truth. We always have to begin with the truth. No matter how ugly, no matter how unpleasant, no matter how unharmonious the truth might be, we got to tell it. You can't walk around here with cancer and I give you cough syrup and tell you that the problem is solved. If you got cancer, you need a major operation, and they need a major operation down there in Sanford, Florida, because the cancer of racism is deep. I've been down there. It's deep. It's like you go down there, that's like the land that time forgot. I'm telling you, they forgot. And not only have they been forgotten, but as someone said earlier, they want to take us back. So we have to have this rally today. But not just this rally, brothers and sisters. We can't have just one rally and somehow feel that we have satisfied our conscience, or somehow feel that justice has been satisfied because we came out here for one day. This struggle may take a year, it may take 2 years, but no matter how long it takes, we got to fight until we get justice for the family of Trayvon Martin.
Amen.
Till we get justice. Yeah. And we got to use every tool at our disposal. If we must march, then we'll march.
Amen.
And if we must vote, then we'll vote. But I tell you this, maybe we shouldn't buy anything that comes out of the state of Florida until we get justice for Trayvon Martin. So I thank the mayor, and I thank the council for having this rally. But I speak today to the young people that are here. I see so many young people. Give those young people a big hand that are here today. And I tell you young people today, this is your issue. This is your time. Each generation has to see and understand its historical task. Fulfill it or betray it. I ask you not to betray it. I ask you to fulfill it. I ask you to all go and be voices for justice in your school and in your church and in your neighborhood and in your community, and get the other young people involved. And you know the greatest tribute you can give to Trayvon Martin is stop the shooting and killing that's going on in our own community. So I tell you, young people, keep up the fight. And I thank the mayor, and I thank the council, and I thank the grassroots leaders that are here today. And all y'all need to join an organization that's fighting for civil rights and fighting for human rights. Join the Irvington branch of the NAACP. Join other organizations. Join the People's Organization for Progress, the National Action Network. But be a part of an organization that's actively fighting
for justice.
Yes.
I am.
I am.
I am.
I am.
I am.
Where is my money?
Thank you. Thank you, Larry. Yeah.